Hey, how you doing? This is Emilio, and in this video, we're going to show you how to block websites on your Mac, specifically sketchy websites, websites that could potentially cause harm to your Mac, introduce malware. We don't want any of that. We're going to show you how to do that in this video. Before we do get into this, this channel is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity technology for humans. Remember to click on that subscription button down below on the bell so you don't miss out on any of our future video releases. So if you're using your Mac, if others, your friends, your family are using their Macs, occasionally you're going to get phishing emails. You're going to navigate to websites that can introduce malware, viruses, things like this onto your Mac. Long gone are the days where the Mac was super safe, you know, as opposed to the other operating system that is a lot more prone to getting attacks and malware and things like this. Nowadays, because the Apple range has grown significantly, it is now more prone to attacks. So nowadays, there are a lot more people, unfortunately, making malicious code, malicious applications for the Mac because the Mac has exploded in popularity. So there's a lot more malware available now than there ever was before, which means there's going to be lots of websites that are going to try to lure you in to be able to install malicious code onto your Mac, to either impact your Mac, to get remote access, to steal data, and we don't want any of that. So what we're going to do is we're going to jump onto our Mac, and we're going to show you how to actually use your browser on your Mac to block some of these sketchy looking websites, to protect your Mac. We'll be showing you primarily on two browsers, on Safari and on Chrome, but other browsers will be similar to the same features that we're going to be showing you right here. All right, let's now jump onto our Mac and we'll show you how to do this. Now, this setting can be used for both Safari and for Google Chrome and other browsers should you choose to do that. We're going to go and open up the system settings, or the old school name of system preferences, essentially. Go into the Apple logo and select system settings. Once that opens up, we're going to scroll down to the section here that says screen time. Opening up screen time, we're going to look at the section under restrictions called content and privacy. This is the spot we can control the privacy for your Mac in general. You'll also note that on iOS devices, this setting is also available to you. Opening this up, we want to look at restricting certain websites. Now, there are going to be certain websites that by default are going to want to go and install malicious code onto your computer. So we want to look at limiting those. We're going to turn this setting on. Now you'll notice that there's a few different settings available to you here. What we're specifically looking for is the one that says web. So App Store, Media, Web, and Games. We're going to open this one up. And we want to look at limiting adult websites, or you can also say allow websites only. By default, yours will probably look like this, where it's going to be completely unrestricted, allowing everything to be open. But if you go and select limit adult websites, it'll obviously limit specific types of websites. But also, if you select customize over here, you can actually now specifically block or allow specific websites. Dodgywebsite.com and say done. That website is now restricted. I can now select on done, and that is now going to block based on a number of different known websites that can contain malicious code, but also will also have these additional ones restricted. If there are specific websites that are being blocked and you don't want them to be blocked, you can also specifically allocate these under the allowed section and they will be opened up. Okay, so for example, I want to make sure that my Moonlock website is not blocked, for example, and I can click on done. So these will be the list of allowed and these will be the list of restricted, and I can select that. I can be even more specific by selecting allowed websites only and customize. So by default, all of these websites will be allowed. And I can actually now have a list of all of my known websites and allow those only, which means every other website will be blocked. Some other general settings that I recommend to look at setting on your Safari to just make sure that websites are controlled and that no malicious code comes in is under the settings section under security, set up the option to warn when visiting a fraudulent website. So if that website contains potentially malicious code, make sure that you are warned ahead of time. Under privacy, you want to look at controlling web traffic. You want to look at hiding your IP address. Within Google Chrome, one thing that you can look at is under the settings section, Chrome settings, you'll be presented with a lot of settings that you can adjust. Within the privacy and security, I'd recommend going through the different sections on here to look at securing some things, because by default, Chrome will identify any websites that are malicious and block those for you. So you can see a setting list of your permissions and adjust things as needed. Under the content section, under pop-ups and redirects, you can look at setting some things on here to make sure that pop-ups do not trigger specific warnings on your websites. Further down, additional content settings has some additional settings that you can look at setting up so you can control the protection of Google Chrome even further. But if you want to get very specific to block specific websites, you will need to install a extension over here. We're going to now select Chrome Web Store. That'll open up a new browser and we're going to search for block site. Let's select the top option and add to Chrome. Once that is done, there will now be an extension over here, which you can select, and you enter in your Sketchy website name right over here. All right, blocking enabled, yes, and that is now done. Now, one final thing that I would recommend just to maintain the security of your Mac through controlling of your websites and malicious code and malware is to go and use Clean My Mac. The first section that I recommend going and checking out is malware removal, where you can actually now do a full scan of your Mac to make sure that everything is clear, that all malware is controlled and removed if you should have any on your Mac. The second, just to control things in future, is under the privacy section. You'll see that it's going to look at your browser's history, any traces of browsing activity that may be malicious. Run a scan. Lots of items identified under Chrome and Safari. I'm going to recommend that you go into each of these and then you clear them out should you suspect something be malicious. Now, this is the best way that you can actually secure your content through your browsing history. So now you know how to block websites on Chrome, on Safari, on your Mac so that you can stay protected for longer. Remembering that the Mac is one of the safest operating systems out there, but it is still prone to malware and phishing. So you want to make sure that you are protected. Hey, if you like this video, let us know down below by giving us a thumbs up. Comment down below as well. And as always, if you don't want to miss out on anything that we are releasing, remember to click on that subscription button and on the bell. And we'll see you on the next video.